Hello, I'm Gavin Hoey and welcome back to my studio. Now today we're going to do another little still life setup using water and a small flash gun. The effect I want to achieve is the effect of water bursting out the top of a bottle. Now that's actually quite difficult to photograph. It's actually much easier to photograph the bottle this way up with the water pouring out, and then we'll reverse it inside of Photoshop. Now before we get into the photography, let's have a little look at the setup. Let's see what we've got. Let's start off with the camera first of all. I'm using a Canon 40D and it's got a standard 24-105 lens on the front, so nothing too fancy there. The fancy bit's actually just on the top here. This is a little remote trigger that's going to fire my flash gun. It's probably the cheapest bit of the whole kit as well. Speaking of flash guns, this is it. This is the Canon 580EX flash gun. Really any flash gun will do. It doesn't have to be particularly powerful for this job. But what it does have at the bottom is the receiver that connects to this transmitter wirelessly. So as soon as I press the button on the camera, it'll fire the flash and there's no messy cables to get in the way. The background, as you can see, is a nice pure white background. It doesn't have to be this big at all. It simply has to be big enough to cover your image from top to bottom. Now, of course, I've got to have some water, so I've got a little supply of water here. I've already put some food colouring in here to give it a nice red colour. And you've got to have somewhere to catch the water as well. You don't really want this just spilling onto your floor, so I've got a little sort of buckety thing here just to catch the water. Now, there's one other little gadget I'd recommend as well, and it's one of these. It's just a towel, really, but it's a vital piece of equipment in the studio if you're photographing water, because the chances are something's going to get wet somewhere along the line, and this little towel could just be the lifesaver you need. Right, that's enough of the equipment. Let's have a look at the camera settings. Now, because I'm using this little wireless trigger, I have to work in manual mode. The shutter speed needs to be the sync speed of your camera, or in my case, I like to set it just a little bit below, just to make sure there's no accidental delays between the trigger and the flash. So in my camera, it syncs at 250th of a second. So I'm actually going to sync it at 200th of a second as the shutter speed. Aperture, well, I'm going to choose f8. And of course, most importantly, I'm going to shoot in RAW to give me maximum possibilities when I get back inside of Photoshop. Now, just like my camera, the flash can't be in its automatic setting. It needs to be in its manual mode. I know from experience it works best for this setup on around about a quarter of its usual power. Now I'm going to place the flash about a metre and a half away from the white background, and we're actually going to point it directly at the background. The idea being the flash will light the background, the light will bounce off and come back through our bottle. Very important to make sure this is pointing right over the bucket. You don't want it to miss, because this is going to get a little bit messy. Not too bad, but a little bit messy. Like that. And then we'll make sure the camera is focused up. Yeah, it's got the focus. And, well, here we go. Excellent. Okay, so there we are. That's it. We've taken a whole bottle full of pictures. Let's do it again. Brilliant. Okay, so that's the water completely emptied down. With a bit of luck, we've got some great pictures there. All we need to do now is get these pictures onto the computer and see what we've got. Where's that towel?